I was looking down there. There's a tree down there. It's busted. It wasn't broken before. I would like to go down there, look around, but you know, it's wet and bugs galore. Maybe I'll go around and
standing here talking to the camera, and it was set on photo. Darn it.
Anyways, I just walked along. There's a trail kind of comes over here. One of these footfall trails. And I'm just describing that back here on this tree a couple of years ago. It's in through there. There were some deer parts hanging on it. They eventually disappeared. And I was just about to say that this is exactly the area right here where it's full on this side of the brush. My son and I saw a large black individual, all fur. It was already moving away from us. It made all kinds of noise. It only went back about here, like just back in here somewhere, and stopped. I said it sounded like it went about 50 feet and stopped. We were putting up a trail camera, and we saw it. We saw it across its back and the back of its head. It was enormous, and I was like, what do you do? We saw it. I was like, did you see that? My son's like, yeah. He wanted to go. At that time, I think he was probably about 14. And anyways, we put the trail camera up and we left. And there was no more sound. Like it felt perfectly safe once you couldn't hear it. But it was back here somewhere. Probably watching us or listening or whatever. Back in here somewhere. That's interesting. Something's been in here digging that all out. Whatever that would have been. I'm not seeing the tree that's newly broken down. This thing is way down there. It's just as nasty getting to it from this side as it was from the other. I'm pretty sure it was wind damage, but I just don't recall any wind enough to break a big tree like that, splinter it all up. And at the same time, I'm pretty sure our friend the Sasquatch out here, he's not strong enough to do that. Like, I'm talking trees this size. I don't think so. Could be wrong. I don't think so though. Now the trail's over there. When you walk on it, you can actually feel where somebody else's feet have been on here. Steps right here, and over here, up through here. Oh hell, I can't see it now. Coming this way. Oh, there it is. Okay. Anyway, up out of there. Wet. In a couple more summers, this is going to be another really thick area. It's going to be just like this in here. I'm not sure if that will affect what goes on here, or will it make it more of an inviting environment for these individuals to come up here? I don't know. I've always thought that this area being open has something to do with their activity. I don't know. A lot of holes and stuff up here. Big divots. And every time I'm here, I record that. I don't really say much about it, but I'll just talk about it here. This has been here for probably for about, I'm going to say 6 years. And some of those branches are trees. Like, they're like 40 feet tall. They go way up there. So even though they're skinny, I'm sure they're quite heavy. Cumbersome anyways. And just right there, you can see the remains of what used to be the original teepee structure back here. And just a couple of the smallest trees are still up against that. Originally, it was stuff like this kind of caliber, big stuff. Pulled up and leaned up against that. I'm just realizing, I just now realized that, let me walk over here. I'm sure it's not here. The tree
I used to put the stones on is gone. Yeah, it's gone. It used to be just right here. And that's not it. That's far too new. And it's gone. That's really something. Oh, did you hear that? That was loud. Something just back there where I just came from is moving through the trees. I hear it. It's moving to my left. Can't see a darn thing, but it's back there, whatever that is. You know, it's changed so much back here over time that this doesn't look anything like what I remembered. I can still see my trail through here, but it's only a trail because it's probably well packed down. Holy heck, I hear something back there. Could be anything. Could be a deer. I don't see anything. But certainly, I heard it over here, though. You can hear it scooting right over there, whatever it was. It wasn't overly noisy, obviously, or at least you would have heard it too, but hopefully the camera picked up the first crack. There are these saplings coming up. Holy cow. This is going to be a forest like none other. One day, maybe not too far away. It's already growing in here. This used to be just like this here. This was all like nothing at one time. I got that strong feeling like something's watching me. Could be wrong. I don't know. Anyway, I'm gonna go down here. Back to my bike. I don't see anything. I definitely have that feeling I almost shouldn't turn my back. Maybe I'm gonna miss something. I don't know. Camera certainly doesn't have the ability to zoom in back there, that's for sure. I really miss using my proper cameras. Telephone's junk. Yeah, sure it does, you know, good pictures and okay, you can record a video with it and all that, but the real camera is the thing to be using, that's for sure. Ducked over a tree right there. Don't remember that one. I was just out here a couple weeks ago. I'm still hearing something back there. Like I said, I think I said in one of the other videos that, you know, appearing to be, you know, kind of nonchalant, like not really paying attention to whatever you may hear, I think it kind of entices these creatures to come out because they think you can't hear them. So, with that said, that's why I typically leave the area, come back, you know, play that back and forth kind of game and see what happens. I'm gonna get back on my bike when I get out there and go around the other side, see if I can find anything. So now I'm back in here looking around. Bugs are still bugging me. Of course. Used to be a trail right through here. I used to walk through here quite a bit. So sometimes people say, you know, how do you even know where you are in that forest? I know exactly where I am. Some of these trails are mine. Other trails are, I'll say they're mine, but they're actually deer trails that I've walked on enough that they've become like regular foot trail.
if you're back here, you can see them. Otherwise, nobody sees them. If anybody's ever around. Check that out. It's kind of cool. Make a good walking stick. Oh my god. It's hot. It's humid. And rain dripping off the leaves. Ugh. Kind of a crummy day. But, you know, it's better than cloudy and cold. See, there's all of these divots in the ground, like, they're everywhere. There's all kinds of spots, you know. Something's seen you coming along, and they know exactly where all this stuff is. I need to get down on one of those and just duck down. Be quiet and walk right on past them. Won't even know it. The trail used to go back that way, but I'm not going back that way. This is the area that, you know, when my kids were small, I guess the one was 13, 12, 13, 14, somewhere in that area. And the other kids were like 5 and 6. And around that general area, back in the days when we used to walk around here wearing their bicycle helmets. Let's take a lot of flack for it. We walked right past a group of wild dogs out here. They were just kind of hunkered down under some bushes. It was a really thick spot underneath a bunch of raspberry or blackberries or whatever. And they were just right in there, as quiet as a mouse. We walked right past them, didn't even know it. And very sharp-eyed viewer said, "Hey, you know, look at this." He blows up the picture and sends it to me from one of the frame of the video. And it's like, I'll be darned. He was right. And it drops off over here into the ravine. Boy, what? I haven't heard any more sounds. Whatever it was, that's way back over that way somewhere. Never heard any more either. Where it was, stopped moving around. Anyway, I'm gonna ride around and see if I can find anything else. If I find anything of interest, I'll be back and I'll film it. Otherwise, thanks for watching. Supergiant Bigfoot.